Hey folks, Dagan here.
I'm Meg.
I'm Sam.
From PMTVUK. And today we are in London at Strong Room Studios. And we've never actually been in the same room before. The three main presenters from PMTVUK, it's the first time we've actually met.
Yeah, we've got some questions that you've sent us and we are going to answer them today.
And you never know, we might even have a cheeky little jam. And before we get started, we just want to say thank you to everyone who has subscribed. We've just hit the milestone of 250,000 subscribers, which is,
it's absolutely
mega.
Crackers. That's over a quarter of a million people care about us chatting about music stuff online.
We just want to say thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, guys. Right, let's get into it. So we have this magic pint glass of questions for all three of us, and let's just pick one out each and see what we have to say. Ready? All right, you guys put these questions forward, so I hope you've all been quite nice. Who would you like to jam with?
Ah, good one.
Well, each other, obviously.
Yeah.
It's going to happen in 10 minutes' time. We've been to jam with you guys for years, so finally it's going to happen.
I've always wanted to jam with Laura Marling, though.
Mm-hmm.
Or Joni Mitchell. Either one of those two. Just
I
put some acoustics
some
in some crazy
Mitchell, yeah.
tunings and see what happens.
Excellent. What about you, Sam?
It's got to be Hendrix, isn't it?
Yeah.
I couldn't really turn down that. And yeah, I'll play a bit of bass for Hendrix.
Yeah.
All right.
I mean, that's what I was thinking before. I was like, I'd love to jam with Eddie Van Halen. But I just get massively shown up and feel very
yeah.
insignificant.
Yeah.
So I'm probably going to say John Mayer.
Yeah.
A nice little kind of bounce back, some bluesy fun. For me, it's John Mayer.
I could play a tambourine.
I'll play some tambourine for EVH, like. Definitely. Yeah. Yeah, that's all great.
Would you rather look into the past or the future?
The future.
Future for me as well. Don't like living in the past.
Yeah, exactly. I agree with that.
I'm the opposite.
You're always in the past, aren't you?
I'm the opposite, yeah. I'll tell you what, and we were talking about this on the way up. I've just finished watching the Beatles Get Back documentary. I don't know if you've seen that, but it's there's something about it that obviously seeing that kind of footage from the late 60s when they're recording and being in those studios.
That is a great point.
I think I prefer to live in that time.
Go back to that time.
Yeah, around about that time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to go back to medieval times when they had like.
I think I would. I'd like to go back to medieval times, yeah. I want to get some nice top hats and cut about the cane.
Oh, that's exactly. I can see that.
Yeah.
Past. Music was better then.
Have you changed your past for you or still future?
I think that's a good. I didn't think of it like that, but I think I'd want to see the future. Although that could be quite, what's the word? Ominous, with given the current state of climate change and all. You might get there and
yeah.
be like, oh, is take it, me back.
Is it getting this heavy already? Right, next question. Pass that pint glass quickly.
Which song is your biggest guilty pleasure?
I am a massive, massive, massive Taylor Swift fan.
Are
huge,
you?
Huge Taylor Swift fan. So it's not even a song. It's like everything Taylor Swift has ever done.
Yeah.
The Red album's fantastic, and it, like, yeah, Taylor Swift.
Red one is that the older one? That's
the Red one is almost blank space on Trouble
yeah.
22. All those songs. Reputation's great, and yeah, the Evermore stuff is just fantastic. Not even guilty. Yeah.
Yeah, that's nice. I think I play Rocket Man like
yeah.
2 to 3 times a week at the moment. That's
Elton John's not a guilty pleasure.
I don't think Elton John's a guilty pleasure, you know, Meg.
Like, tell you what for me and Jim been
Venga
the
Boys.
London oh that sort of stuff does come on, but we
yeah.
have been putting this will be my guilty pleasure. Bryan Adams with featuring Mel C. That When You're Gone song. I think it slaps.
That definitely counts.
About you, Sam?
I grew up listening to, I love kind of old cheesy 90s rap.
Mm.
And as you know, I can rap the entire verse to, was it Ice Ice Baby?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Love a bit of Vanilla Ice. What inspired you guys to play music?
For me, it was my dad putting on AC/DC live at River Plate at Donington Park when Angus Young was there with his, on the walkway playing Thunderstruck.
Yeah.
I was like, that's the coolest thing in the world.
Yeah.
I want to do that. And then I immediately saw Queen. It was Brian May playing. So I was like, that's amazing. Then it was the Sex Pistols. I was like, this is really cool. And all three of them together.
That was
now
it.
I'm here and I play SGs.
Here we are.
Yeah.
Well, I used to do a lot of dancing. And basically, I must have just been really keen for performing as a child. But my mum just didn't quite find where it was meant to be till I got to about 12. But yeah, I used to do like drama shows and dance shows. And I knew I wanted to be some sort of singer, because that was my favourite part of all of it.
Mm.
Then I got a guitar, and that was it.
Was it singer first, or songwriter, or how did that kind of...
I wanted to write songs from, like, the age of 11. They, if we ever found them, would probably be one of the worst things you've ever read. But I definitely liked the songwriting quite early on. But I did singing lessons from a very young age, so I just loved singing.
Cool. What about you, Sam?
I started playing at a young age just out of, you need to do something, how about playing the piano? And kind of learned a few of the classical things, did a couple of grades, but didn't really necessarily connect to it. My old man was playing records all the time. I've got a bit of a soft spot for some, talking about guilty pleasures, people like, you know, some of the cheesy Dire Straits stuff, things like that. I've got a real special place. But for me, it probably was seeing, I think it was the Freddie Mercury tribute concert. I remember watching on old black and white TV.
Yeah.
And coming from kind of playing classical pieces where everything had to be sitting upright and all this kind of thing, to seeing, you know, some of the other, obviously George Michael singing Somebody Loves, the one that everyone remembers from that gig.
Yeah. But,
and then obviously from there, seeing other gigs and things, it just made me think, it's amazing that this kind of, you know, you can connect with so many people through something that it's difficult to quantify in music.
Yes.
It's kind of, it's just, it's not a physical thing, but it means so much to so many people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it just got me excited.
Nice. Great show.
Might be a question for you, Dagan. Mm-hmm. Is what was Dagan's first band?
Sam can answer that first if he. No. a band called Plain and Dirty.
Oh.
And it was N, Plain and Dirty.
Plain.
With John Arkle, who manages the PMT Newcastle store right now.
Lovely guy.
John playing the guitar, I played bass. I wore too much eyeliner, my hair touched the ceiling wherever I went, and I only wore cowboy boots, and I was like 14. Yeah, Plain and Dirty. Don't
genre
don't
in like
it.
Short explained
genre
was,
was crappy Guns N' Roses.
Right.
Yeah. Next question.
Nice.
Before we delve too deep.
What's your first band? Or because you're a solo.
Yeah, I did join a country, but the country band I'm in, I joined it originally when I was like 15.
So did you always want to be a solo artist, like from when you first started playing music and stuff?
Yeah, I always wanted to be a songwriter, really. Mm-hmm. So the singer-songwriter route was probably desirable. Although now obviously, I love collaborating, so. And I'd also quite like to be a bass player in like a funky band or something, so.
Yeah.
I love all the folk stuff, obviously, but I do find myself sometimes just wanting to
funk it up with
funk
bass.
Funk it up on stage, yeah.
All right, you, Sam, first band?
Oh, mine, it was. I used to play the keyboards before I played guitar. I was in a school band, bizarrely, with a few of my friends, and we had the worst name because it was Sam. Myself, a guy called Ollie, a guy called Ben, and a guy called Adam. We used to do like all these really awful kind of like Hank Marvin covers and all that kind of thing. But yeah, we called ourselves Sober, which was the acronym of our names, because we thought that would make sense. We even had kind of glittery t-shirts with Sober written down the front. Yeah, it was terrible.
Nice.
Yeah, that was my first band. And it went downhill from there.
Would you rather wrestle 10 duck-sized me's or one me-sized duck?
10 tiny ones, I think.
10 tiny ones or one me-sized duck?
I can't imagine how intimidating that would be, just that giant, like,
tiny
really
ones would be
tall.
Too cute, though, wouldn't they? Could you imagine, like, 10 little Dagans?
I reckon you'd love kicking
around
a bit.
Yeah.
Taking a run up.
I reckon.
Absolutely,
properly.
Seeing how you could kick it across the room.
I reckon
Stuart
the
Pearce penalty, straight over.
I reckon the vegan imbi would come out. I'd befriend them all.
Whack-a-Dagan.
Whack-a-Dagan, yeah. That's a great little PM2 gift for next year, 2022. Whack-a-Dagan. Or one massive duck.
What was the last musical purchase you made? I bought a classic vibe Jag bass, like a short scale one, so I could practice bass at home. I think that was the last thing that I bought.
I find it's really difficult when you work in a store because there's just so much kind of stuff.
Wasn't that telly for you probably, wasn't it?
Yeah, I bought a Nashville Telecaster just because I wanted something a little bit versatile, and I bought a Nashville Telecaster. I bought quite a few pedals recently as well.
For me, I think it was one of the new Black Star Dep 10 dual drives. The new little red ones that you reviewed and then I reviewed, I've absolutely fallen in love with it. And it's not the most expensive, that's like £250 or something.
Yeah.
But it sounds like a 400, 500 quid distortion pedal. Like proper boutique thing. So yeah, it's the Dep 10 for me.
And I'm hoping Dagan can answer through experience on this one. Would you rather have a mullet or a perm?
Mullet. Yeah. Business
kind of
at
got
the
both,
front.
Haven't you?
Yeah, business at the front, party at the back. Mullet all the way.
I've always wanted a perm for a little bit, so I'll say perm.
Oh, I'm rocking the mullet at the moment. I kind of didn't get my hair cut throughout lockdown, then kind of didn't shave through lockdown, and now I can't get a we're quite close to Christmas, so I can't get an appointment with a hairdresser. So good thing we're not
like
filming
it
today.
Rough a look. Let it all grow out, man.
What was your first instrument?
Drum kit. I had a drum kit. Yeah. Nice. First electric guitar was a Rocket guitar, which came in a bundle pack with a Marshall amp.
Nice.
It's one of those, like, essentially a Squire starter pack now, but Marshall's variant 10 years ago.
I might have had the same one. Same thing, I think.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Nice.
Good, nice.
I think violin was mine, but I hated it. I really hated it, but I did that for about 2 years.
I always feel bad for violin players that start out. For their immediate family and neighbours.
Oh God, yeah, I think that's what put me off so much. They'd be like, "Shut up!" And then guitar. Oh, swim in maple syrup or Nutella? As a vegan, I would have to say maple syrup.
I'm not a big chocolate fan, so yeah, I'll probably go with syrup as well. Sticky though.
It would be sticky.
I'm just gonna say Nutella to be different.
Oh.
Yeah, I haven't got a strong feeling either way. So just to not upset whoever asked that question, I'm going to go for Nutella.
I think we probably know the answer to the question. It's definitely for Dagan on this one. Do you have any tattoos?
No.
No, I can't see any.
No, I draw them on. If you look closely, they're all different.
Every single. It's like
roses, 13 there, LM there. I say Carpe Diem on my chest. And a really cringy one is I've got two massive guns there. Which I'm not going to show, but I've got two massive pirate guns on my stomach that point to the middle.
You got that as well, haven't you, Sam?
Yeah.
No, I've got one little tree. It's the first ever EP I did when I was younger. My cousin drew the artwork and then I got it on my arm.
That's nice though, it's a nice little.
Yeah.
It's cooler than two massive pirate guns.
Well.
What are you saying?
No, I am totally boring when it comes to tattoos. Although
that's the new cool though, isn't it?
Is it?
No tattoos.
There we go.
Yeah.
Well, I think I did used to be in a. I used to be in the Chili Peppers tribute band.
Mm. Yeah.
And yeah, I used to wear the tattoo sleeves that you can get off eBay for like £2.
Get it.
Yeah, I look terrible in tattoos. So no, I'm totally boring.
What was the first album you bought?
Whatever the Steps album is, whatever the first Steps album that they released was, it's like a grey cover. I couldn't tell you what it's called, but that's the first album that I bought.
Do you still listen to it now?
Yeah, all the time.
Well, in Strong Room Studios, it's not Steps, but the Spice Girls recorded Wannabe in this studio.
That is very cool.
What, this room?
Yeah.
The
plaque outside.
Oh, I must have missed that.
Yeah.
Amazing. Plaque on the wall.
Yeah, really cool.
So the history in this room, and now where are you?
Here we are.
Which one was your favourite Spice Girl? Well, I'm coming off the cuff here, but...
Posh for me. Always been posh.
Oh, scary.
Yeah?
What are you?
Sporty.
Sporty?
The underdog.
Oh, well, see, yeah?
I can't say that. Come on, video. Yeah.
What was the first album you bought?
Actually, my first album... it's going to sound like I'm making this up, but actually it's not an uncool album. Appetite for Destruction.
Wow.
But... I bought it, I must have been about 10 years old, at a car boot sale with my pocket money, because I liked the cover of it.
Yeah.
I didn't really know much about music. And I bought it on cassette, 50p, something like that. Put it on the car stereo. My mum got Welcome to the Jungle's first song, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I think I got away with that, but then it goes straight into, is it How to Get Me?
Yes.
Yeah, basically we got about two songs in and it went out the window. I wasn't allowed that album.
Oh, man. For me, the first album I ever bought with my own money, I think when you're a kid, like your parents buy you stuff, was My Chemical Romance, The Black Parade. That album changed a lot for me back in the day.
Oh, I think that's...
Is this the last question?
That might be the last question.
Better be good. Who was your biggest musical influence?
Wow, that is a good question to end on,
That's a great question
it?
To end on.
Well done, everyone.
What made me play guitar was Angus Young, Brian May, Steve Jones from the Sex Pistols, turned into the whole 80s thing with Van Halen and Motley Crue
and
stuff.
It's like a mixture, isn't it?
Yeah, and you kind of mature with artists and stuff. So those are mine. What about you guys?
Mine would be like Paul Simon, Joan Baez, Joni Mitchell,
for me personally, I'm quite into some of the weirder, more experimental aspects of it. I'd definitely say Radiohead, one of my favourite bands throughout their entire career, just because of the kind of different genres and things I've covered. Yeah, I'd probably say Radiohead. Yeah.
That's fine.
So thanks for watching, guys. We've finally done it in the same room after how many years?
Many years. I've enjoyed the fact there's been questions as well, because these are the kind of things we would talk about in a pub anyways.
Yeah.
So which now we're just doing it on
definitely
camera.
What we're going to be doing in a minute.
Christmas is just around the corner recording this, so yeah, it's true. Yeah, it's been cool.
Thank you again for the 250,000 of you joining us on this channel. If there is anything that you really want to see from us, any type of content, let us know in the comments section.
And with that as well, speaking of content, if there's any up-and-coming DJs, producers, studio engineers, all the folk out there that enjoy all that techie stuff that personally we aren't really familiar with, but we're the biggest music company in the UK, so we want to expand our channel into the whole tech world. So any DJs out there, any studio guys, if you think you have what it takes to be part of the PMTVUK team, send through why you think you'd be perfect for the job in an email to submissions@pmtonline.co.uk. Why it'd be perfect, any social media links that you want to include, any videos yourself, and we'll be in contact if you think you've got what it takes to join me, Sam and Meg here.
Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. Hope you're enjoying the content. We'll see you again soon.
Cheers.